الحمد لله رب العالمين، رب العالمين يا رب. سبحانك اللهم خير معلم، علمت بالقلم القرون الأولى، أرسلت بالتوراة موسى هاديا، وبن البتول فعلم الإنجيلا، وبعثت أحمد بالكتاب فشرعه أتممت إذ فصلته تفصيلا. الله أكبر، إن دين محمد وكتابه أقوى وأقوم قيلا. لا تذكر الكتب السوالف قبله، طلع الصباح فأطفئ القنديلا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، حبب إلينا الإيمان وزينه في قلوبنا، وكره إلينا الكفر والفسوق والعصيان، وجعلنا من الراشدين. وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله، وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه، بلغ العلا بكماله، كشف الدجى بجماله، عظمت جميع خصاله، صلوا عليه وآله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك وأنعم على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه حق قدرهم ومقدارهم العظيم. وارض اللهم عن الأربعة الخلفاء سيدنا أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي، وارض عنا معهم يا رب العالمين، آمين. ثم أما بعد، my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, it is my honor to welcome you all to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to the Sha'ira of Jum'ah. We ask Allah the Almighty to make all of us among those about whom Allah says, وَبَشِّرْ عِبَادِي الَّذِينَ يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقَوْلَ فَيَتَّبِعُونَ أَحْسَنَهُ أولئك الذين هداهم الله وأولئك هم أولو الألباب. Give glad tidings, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to my servants. Those when they listen to a sermon or a word of wisdom or an advice, they follow the best of it. My dear brothers and sisters, last week we talked about where we stand in regard to the new lifestyle that some people here and all over the world have taken, known as LGBTQ, and we said it is very ungodly, it is immoral, it indicates that we are going backward, and also indicate lack of respect for our humanness. Playing with the, or making games with the construction of the human being that been made by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is very dangerous, and it is very corruptive. But whatever people might choose, that is their business with God. We have to make it clear that Islam condemns that. It is forbidden in Islam. It is against God, against our very humanness. But if somebody chooses to do that, we ask God for them to be guided and to lead good life instead of following the footsteps of Shaitan. And today we gonna be talking about we as Muslims, we should not compromise our faith. Some people feel inferior, feel weak, they live in fear. If we say or we do not follow or we do not condone what people are doing, people gonna bother us. People gonna call us bad citizen. You do not belong, which is very strange. The people who are godly, so godly, stick to their morality, they become very abnormal. And the people who are abnormal, they have all support from government, from media, and even from religious organization. And it is very, very alarming to see even some Muslim leaders cannot speak openly about it. So my advice is, do not ever compromise on your faith. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never did. Sometimes people say, let us hold the stick from the middle to please the right one and the left one. No. In religion, there is no holding the stick from the middle. There is no moderation in faith. There is no adjustment. There is no amendment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Surah Al-Isra 17:74, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِن كَادُوا لَيَفْتِنُونَكَ عَنِ الَّذِي أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ لِتَفْتَرِيَ عَلَيْنَا غَيْرَهُ وَإِذًا لَاتَّخَذُوكَ خَلِيلًا وَلَوْلَا أَن ثَبَّتْنَاكَ لَقَدْ كِدْتَ تَرْكَنُ إِلَيْهِمْ شَيْئًا قَلِيلًا إِذًا لَأَذَقْنَاكَ ضِعْفَ الْحَيَاةِ وَضِعْفَ الْمَمَاتِ ثُمَّ لَا تَجِدُ لَكَ عَلَيْنَا نَصِيرًا. Very strong and very powerful warning. To whom? To Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَإِن كَادُوا لَيَفْتِنُونَكَ. They are doing their best to make you, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, compromise, to make you deviate, to make you hold the stick from the middle. لِتَفْتَرِيَ عَلَيْنَا غَيْرَ, that you may falsify another book or another sharia or another way of life. If you do so, they're gonna become your best friend, the closest friend. وَلَوْلَا أَن ثَبَّتْنَاكَ, have we not supported you, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لَقَدْ كِدْتَ تَرْكَنُوا إِلَيْهِمْ شَيْئًا قَلِيلًا. You are about to give them very little. Then, if you do so, لَأَذَقْنَاكَ ضِعْفَ الْحَيَاةِ وَضِعْفَ الْمَمَاتِ. Your punishment to Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم will be double in this life and the life to come. That is very strong warning, not to you and me, but to Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. And people were so eager just to make him compromise a little bit. And the promise, Wafd Thaqif came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said, Ya Muhammad, we are willing to believe. You are a good man, we know you. You always invite to the truth. But just to give us something. The riba we have, make it ours. The riba that is against us, wave it away. Ya Muhammad, we are ready to believe, but give us 1 year to worship our Allah, our idol, our God. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said no. Said 1 month, said no. 1 day, said no. Even 1 hour. And they asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if you want to break our God, our idol, do not let us break it with our hand. Let someone else do that. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, yes. Why? Because the main thing is the idol to be broken. Who broke it? No big deal. So the ways and the means, yes, we can adjust. We can see what make what attracted him to Islam. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Abu Sufyan radiallahu anhu to break their God a lot. They said, Ya Muhammad, put on us, put off for us the salah. We are ready to do everything but no salah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, La khayra fi deenin laysa fihi salah. There is no good about a religion that has no connection, that you cannot serve Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That was Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Many ways to try. Utbah came to him and they said, Ya ibn akhi, let us talk about it. There is no one came, لا يوجد رجل أشأم على قومه منك. You Muhammad are a source of misery and bad luck for us. No one been like that before. What is that religion you came with? If you need money, we'll give you money. If you want to be a leader in control, we'll make you our leader. If you want to marry, we'll get you the most beautiful woman in Arabia. If that what brought you this religion, it is some kind of mental issues or a jinn have touched you, we'll do our best to cure you. Can you imagine? They give that offer to who? To Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to compromise. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with all respect told him, أَفَرَغْتَ يَا أَبَا الْوَلِيدِ Are you done? Remember, he never call him names, never curse him, never say, get out of here. أَفَرَغْتَ يَا أَبَا الْوَلِيدِ with the nickname, which he means respect. Yes, we may differ. Like from the earth to the sky, to the heaven. From here to China, big differences. But we cannot lose respect for one another. You may argue with the people who have this lifestyle, but do not ever lose respect. Because Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah told him, Udu'u ila sabil rabbika bilhikma wal maw'idatil hasana. Always speak the right word. Hikmah means wisdom. You have to consider the person you are talking to, his level of education, his tribal background, and his understanding. That is why Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam managed with all people, the Christians, the Jews, the hypocrites, everybody. And he gained the utmost respect. So we are here, brothers and sisters. So we are in a something called the Cold War. You know, the hot war and the cold war. This is the cold war, try to break our morale. Try to seduce our children. We cannot imagine that in the school where education and the disciplining children and the building their morality and their mental capacity, that a teacher have to decide for your son and your son or your child if he is in the right body or not. You are a male but in a body of a female, or a female in a body of a male. You need transgender. So that is why Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam cannot give that much. And the most difficult situation is when someone help you all the way. Your best friend, your mentor, your wali help you from A to Z. And one day he come to say, enough. If you do not give up on that, I'm not with you anymore. That happened with Abu Talib, the uncle of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya ibn akhi, abqi alayya wa ala nafsik, wa la tukallifni min al-amri ma la utiq. Enough, Muhammad. Make it easy. I cannot stand in front of the leaders of Quraysh. And he helped Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم more than anybody. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم lost his father, his mother, his grandfather in early age. The one who stood with him all the way was Abu Talib. فوالله لن يصلوا إليك بجمعهم حتى أوسد في التراب دفينا. I will never give up on you, my nephew. But that day he came and he said, Muhammad, make it easy. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam cannot compromise. And he said it very clearly. Wallahi ya ammi, la wada'u shamsa fi yamini, wal qamara fi yasari, ala an atruka hadha al-amra ma taraktuhu abada, hatta yudhirahu Allahu aw ahlaka fi sabili. If they gonna do everything, even to get the sun from its orbit, and they put it in my right hand, and the moon in my left hand, I will never compromise. That was Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and it should be true to each and every one of us. No one worthy, even my father and my mother, I owe them for everything in my life. I kiss their hand and their feet every day. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِن جَاهَدَاكَ عَلَىٰ أَن تُشْرِكَ بِي مَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِهِ عِلْمٌ فَلَا تُطِعْهُمَا بَطْ وَصَاحِبْهُمَا فِي الدُّنْيَا مَعْرُوفًا. Be kind, be respectful, but do not ever listen to them. So Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never ever compromise. And when we read the history of the prophets of Allah, we read about Yusuf alayhi salam. أنا راودته عن نفسه. I tend to him to do evil thing. ولئن لم يفعل ما آمره ليسجنن وليكون من الصاغرين. If Yusuf doesn't do what I command him to do the evil act with me, the wife of the governor, who is he? He is my boy. What did Yusuf alayhi salam say? He has every reason, every excuse to compromise. They are the one who bought him. It is considered their slave, their servant. Whatever they command, he should listen and obey. And he's away from his family. He's a young man. He has a desire, burning desire. Yet, that is the role model for all of us, brother, and our children. What did he say? قال ربي السجن أحب إلي مما يدعونني إلي وإلا تصرف عني كيدهن أصب إليهن وأكن من الجاهلين فاستجاب له ربه فصرف عنه كيدهن إنه هو السميع العليم. ربي السجن, to be thrown in the prison, dearer to me than to do what they ask me to. And not only the wife of Al-Aziz, also the other niswa. The other niswa become guru. Everybody wanted him. But he never gave away. Never compromise. Why brothers and sisters? Life is about compromise, not in deal. Anything you compromise on, There is a chance if we lose our money, if we lose our deal, if we lose our job, don't, Allah will make the way out for you. As long as Allah always in your mind and you do what Allah, what make Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala happy with you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا وَيَرْزُقْهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبُ. You worry about your business, your money, your risk? Don't worry. Allah is going to make the way out for you. As long as you are with Him, you please no one but Him. So that is why, brothers and sisters, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to ask Allah, saying, Allahumma la taj'al musibatana fi deenina. Any calamity, we can take it. It weaken us, it bend us, but we're gonna stand up again. Losing a child, losing a business, losing money, losing a citizenship, being in jail, called the names, we are not better than Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Call him names. They got the stomach of the jazur, a camel, and they put it on the head of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Put the dust on him, calling him names. And where are they? And where is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Muhammad, every second in the whole world, the name of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is mentioned. وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ. Where are they now? All of them died in the battle of Badr. And Allah break their morale, and they break their leadership and their ego. But Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam remained the most high human being all over the world. So that is why, brothers and sisters, but musiba indeed cannot be fixed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ هَلْ نُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِالْأَخْسَرِينَ أَعْمَالًا. Shall I tell you with the real loser? الَّذِينَ ضَلَّ سَعْيُهُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَهُمْ يَحْسَبُونَ أَنَّهُمْ يُحْسِنُونَ صُنْعًا. The people who lost their faith and their religion. That is why, brothers and sisters, when we read Allah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Surah Al-Zukhruf, Surah Al-An'am, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِ مُسْتَقِيمًا فَاتَّبِعُوهُ وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا السُّبُلَ فَتَفَرَّقَ بِكُمْ عَنْ سَبِيلِهِ. Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu said, one day we are sitting with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and on the sand he got a branch of a tree and he made one straight line in the sand. And he said, وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِ مُسْتَقِيمًا فَاتَّبِعُوهُ. This is the sirat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so straightforward. Follow it. Then he made small lines on both sides, right and left. Curving, crooked. And he said, وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا السُّبُلَ فَتَفَرَّقَ بِكُمْ عَنْ سَبِيلِهِ. Don't follow other ways and means and roads and lifestyle, ideology, religions whatsoever. They're gonna take you away from the sirat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we ask Allah for 17 times a day when we only make the fard. 17 raka'ah, which is ihdina sirat al-mustaqim, sirat al-ladina an'amta alayhim ghayr al-maghdubi alayhim wala al-dallin. Therefore, brothers and sisters, when we read our salah every day, we should remember what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran in Surah Al-An'am 151 to 53 in Surah Al-An'am. Allah talk about the 10 commandments. قُلْ تَعَالَوْا أَتْلُ مَا حَرَّمَ رَبُّكُمْ عَلَيْكُمْ أَلَّا تُشْرِكُوا بِاللَّهِ وَبِالْوَلَدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا وَلَا تَقْتُلُوا أَوْلَادَكُمْ. And the last one, verse 153, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِ مُسْتَقِيمًا. And that is my straight way. What is that hada? All the Ten Commandments before. Which is, you shall not kill, you shall not commit shirk, you shall not do this and that. يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم كل بني آدم خطاء وخير الخطائين التوابون أو كما قال ادعوا الله يستجب لكم. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونتوكل عليه ونستزيده ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله السميع البصير وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا البشير النذير اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. My dear brothers and sisters, sometimes because of ignorance or fear or feeling inferior, we give away our religion. We try to compromise. It doesn't matter if you are the best Muslim or not. When you stand for the truth you believe, even if I am wrong, let us say, God forbid, somebody have drinking problem. It does not mean to say drinking is halal. If somebody does not attire, or a brother or a sister does not attire himself rightly, it doesn't mean that is right to do that. We ask Allah to forgive all of us. But when you come to talk about your religion, faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have to have a sense of honesty. A lady might maybe not wearing a hijab. But when you talk, say yes, hijab is a must. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addressed the wives of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya qul li banatika wa azwajika wa banatika wa nisa'il mu'minin. Some people think it is only for the wives of Muhammad. Wa nisa'il mu'minin, who are we? Who are the believers? Our wives, our daughter, our nisa'. Yudnina alayhinna min jalabi bihin. Surah al-Nisa' and Surah al-Nur, Surah al-Ahzab. Allah talk about it. But when we come to say, yes, it is a must, but I ask Allah to guide me, to give me the power to do that. Drinking is bad, I ask Allah to rid me from this bad habit. Yes, we have to do that. Sense of honesty. Can you imagine a lady who been chosen to be represent not only the Muslim but American in a big organization, no need to mention. Speak on the behalf of the American people, including Muslims. And she's from Arab background, and she's a Muslima. To write one day that shame on us, shaming the whole Muslim. Why? Because the Quran been with us for 14 centuries, never been revised. Never been revised. Why? Because she is the Congress or the Senate or whatever. She want to show them how civilized, how updated. I am a good person. I'm living the American dream. Who care about American dream? By the way, the good American, they can respect you when you respect yourself and your faith and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the time you give away, they have no respect whatsoever. That is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made all people come to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and to surrender to him. Why? Because of his stand. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the verse of Surah Al-Kursi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَنْ يُؤْمِنْ وَيَكْفُرْ بِالطَّاغُوتِ فَقَدْ اسْتَمْسَكَ بِالْعُرْوَةِ الْوُثْقَى لَنْ فِصَامَ لَهَا. This is the hand of hope, the strongest hand of hope. That never break. When we hold fast to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored us with. Allahumma afir bifadlika lil muslimina wal muslimat wal mu'minina wal mu'minat al ahya'i minhum wal amwat innaka sami'un qareebun mujibud du'a'i ya rabbal alameen. Allahumma la tada' lana dhanban illa ghafarta wala hamman illa farrajta wala ayban illa satarta wala maridan illa shafayta ولا ميتا إلا رحمته ولا حاجة إلا قضيتها ويسرتها يا رب العالمين. عباد الله، أسأل الله الكريم رب العرش العظيم أن يغفر لي ولكم ولأمة محمد أجمعين. وأقم الصلاة.